with your seat completely clear for landing. Please now check that your table is folded away, your seat is in the landing position with the armrest down, and your seatbelt is securely fastened.
For a week, we were the stars of our very own Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants film adaptation. Lex, Emily, Marion, Sana and I went to Corfu together in May, a girls' trip we'd wanted to take for years, and finally, with Emily about to move to Canada and the timing sort of working out with my visiting home, the island was our temporary paradise. Corfu has had many rulers and allegiances, Venetian, British, and now Greece of course, but its longest owner has been mythology. It features in scripts as old as 1300 BC, and its oral history is woven into the fabric of the great Greek pantheon of storytelling. In anticipation of the trip, we had made our own mythology and rejected certain gods. I wouldn't look at my phone to check my email or bring my laptop. We divided up the tasks of finding places to eat, drink, explore, swim, and in my case, made a playlist. We all made a cognizant effort to respect the rules we'd made for ourselves and each other. This trip was to be protected.
Great one, Dad.
Make a decision!
Oh no!
What?
What's he doing?
Among us, Emily was the only one who felt comfortable driving. Lex and I don't even have licenses, and so she kindly volunteered to drive a car if we'd rented one. Around the curves of the island, the water was always there, patient, waiting. And we thundered on, getting a sense of the island, climbing dunes, sitting out on our hotel patio at night, eating a lot of baklava every day, and being with each other. It's rare that we're all in the same place these days, unless group text is a place, and this was about to become scarcer. Part of me felt like I was so aware of the tropes of girls' trips that I didn't know whether I was experiencing something firsthand or reenacting what I'd seen somewhere. But in any case, I was there with people I loved, in sunsets at night, blasting the Jurassic Park theme at full volume. And the sea, still waiting, was there to watch too. Patient and, like us, thundering on. We hiked to a remote bay where the water was clear and calm, and I felt like I'd been made a secret keeper. Currents heated parts of the bay naturally, others were cool and refreshing after the sweaty hike. And then we made our way back. On our last day, we headed into Corfu town before sunset, and it's here that the island's past is most clearly delineated. Venetian buildings and very European placards. We'd eaten so well every day, fresh and delicious food that as much felt like the soundtrack to our holiday as Haim, Lord, ABBA and the Jurassic Park theme. As dusk fell around us and our credits rolled, I thought again of the water, just out of sight from our dinner, but still there. There through the history of the island, there when the corroded buildings were new, when the castle still stood, when the roads didn't carry British tourists, when there were no roads, no people, just land and sea. And it made me think, how strange we are, how destructive, and yet, how hopeful.